What is going on, geeks? Welcome back to another episode of Ark Scorched Earth from the Molten Iron Server. My name is Unite the Clans, and this, I think, is what, episode 11, I think. Today, guys, we are going to be doing, I got a lot in the works. We've got to finish this base. Now, last couple episodes, you've seen me get this thing in the works. I have a few little structural changes I want to make to get it just looking perfect. And that's going to be part one. We are headed up, and we're going to make some few minor changes, get this place looking tip-top. And then, for the second part of the video, we are going to be joined by a friend of mine, another one of the YouTubers, Arali the Geek, who I think you guys haven't seen since episode one on this server. He's going to come by and help us for the interior design. I've got all kinds of cool essentials for a good, complete base. Speaking of which, Arali and I planted some crops here, looking good. So Arali's going to come over for the second part, help us decorate the interior, and he's also going to help us pick out some paints and do a paint job on the place. I got a good idea of what I want, but we got to get to work. So I have my RG on the top of this place, and we're going to start up there. I don't think, there's a few little things that have changed since you guys saw me last. If you watched, if you haven't, episodes 9 and 10, we build this place. Base building episodes, but this roof is not what I want right now. So we're gonna get this guy over here onto this little raised part, and what I want to do is actually extend this raised part in a couple directions. So we're gonna grab a few of what we need. Let me get what we need and I'll be right back with you guys. Alright guys, so we need to extend this sloped roof. I want this upper level of this base to be, don't fall through, good. I forgot how much materials I'm going to end up with on me, but we want this upper level to be more spacious, and ooh, that might have been bad. I think a few things were supported by that, so, right. Okay, so let's get a ceiling. Do I have ceilings? No, I don't. Okay, let's go ahead and throw in our sloped roof right here, and I'll go grab some ceilings and try and repair that damage. You never quite know what's linked to each other when you've been building a base like this. Ooh, okay, so that's the sound of an electrical storm coming in. I gotta get my butt to work. Okay, guys, so we wanted to extend this, and in destroying it, I actually knocked down a wall I didn't want to knock down. So we now have a little room created that's either going to be a bedroom or space for a generator. And to get it looking the way we want to look, I think that should snap to there. Yeah. Okay, so there's some things on some funky building grids here, and I actually think I may be able to destroy this and replace it now. So let's see if that'll line back up, and it does. Okay, so we fixed one of our building grid issues. So that's gonna go there. Above it, we wanna do a wall. Could do a windowed wall, but I don't think it's necessary. So we'll have that there. You'll be able to come in here. Oh, that's not gonna work. Okay, we need another door frame above there. So we'll do that, and then this'll be your way in. And now we can complete the sloped roof. So the flow that I want to get from the base is when you come up these stairs, I want you to have a way to get down to that little balcony and that little room. So here's the little balcony. And if you go in here, it's going to take you into a little room. We're actually going to slap a door frame backwards right here. And I'll end up, when I grab them, putting a ladder right there. So we'll have a little hidden room up there. You'll be able to access it through that door or by going down here and into this little door. Now, we also have a door frame here. I'm wondering if we need it. We'll see. It's kind of like a kind of a goofy setup we got going on now because I've changed the design a few times. But let's get our butts back up on the roof, and I'll show you what we're doing up there because that's where most of the action is happening. So we've completed this chunk of sloped roof. And then from here, what we've got, I want to continue the sloped roof all along, whoops, this edge to mirror the slope we've got down there. So to do that, we are going to need, is it that one? No, it's the other one that I've taken off my hotbar. All right, so let's get these on the hotbar. And we'll go number four, whoops, number four. And we'll put that there, and then that's going to form the beginning point of another series of slopes. So we've got all below us here windows, and I want to continue that look. So we'll slap a window here, we'll slap a window here. And this is another one of those spots that's on a super weird building line. I'm not sure if I can fix it or if I have the extra walls to fix it, but we'll try. No, it's not going to want to play along. It's just been, I've made some mistakes, but we'll live with it. Okay, so this is the rough shape of this upper level. Now, eventually I want to destroy a few more of these, pretty much the ones over the sloped roof, and I'll see where to go from there. But let's knock that out and we'll start slapping in more slopes to line up with these. Alright guys, so that is the look I wanted to get. It's going to look really good from this side. Now to do it, I've kind of had to make a few tweaks because every time I did I had stuff collapsing down there. So I want to make sure we don't lose any of the integrity of this. This area is actually going to stay a hidden little level. It'll be storage or it'll be another bedroom. So what we want to do is close this in with walls. All right, guys, this is starting to come together. I'm sorry, there's been a little bit of tricky bits, so I've been cutting away. But this is roughly what I had in mind. And the last step is to close in this little area here with some ceilings. And I just want to try and get them to snap all to the same grid. And I'm not sure, maybe the best place to start is over here, because I've got some funky ceilings in this place, and I know it. So we'll try and do this even with my RG floating overhead here. And I want to get this done, guys, so my man Arali can stop by. This is one of those bases where I'm just gonna live with the problems I've already made. I'm not too much of a perfectionist, so that's roughly what I want. At some point, I want to throw a hatch frame in here. I can make one, so let's do that. I think this was the best spot for it, so I'll just throw it up there. I just want a way to get up to the roof if we need it. And now that's on a different grid. Oh well, one of those. So let's back up and we'll take a look at this now. So the changes we've made, we've now extended this section that goes above the upper balcony. We've extended that further back until it meets the sloped roof. And the sloped, we've got windowed walls now going even one step higher over here. And the real money shot you were about to see is over here. When we look at it from this side, this is my favorite view of the place. Alright guys, one important step for a base like this, windows and doors. Now I like getting all the natural light in here I can, but the problem is sandstorms. When a sandstorm hits, if you get your windows open, it's getting inside your house and it's debilitating you and it's draining your stamina. So what we're going to do, and the windows are key to this place because they're going to be bright colors. They're going to be bright colors that really accentuate this adobe. So I'm going to go ahead and slap windows in every single one, and the key to keeping all this awesome natural light is an electrical keypad. So Arali and I are going to set that up as soon as he gets here. We're going to link all the windows to the same key code. I'm going to put it probably somewhere over here, and we're going to be able to open everything and close everything in one go. So that when the sandstorm hits, I'll just run down here, I'll lock it up, and then when it's not, we just kick everything back open. Place looks bright and sunny again. But until then, I'ma hustle. I'ma get all these doors in because Arali is here any minute. All right, be right back, guys. Oh, welcome back, guys. I am with Arali the Geek. You coming over to help me finish this place?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what I have in mind, if you can help me with it, we got a bunch of materials ready for building up the inside. This is the base for Arali's viewers that I've been working on for the last few episodes on my channel. And today, first thing we're going to do, paint job. And I got a good idea for a paint job. And then you're going to help me with the complicated interior, like wires and generators and stuff that I've never done.
Yeah, buddy.
People have been watching my channel a long time. They'll realize, holy crap, UTC is a fabricator. I've never seen that. I've never seen him not be a basic primitive loser. So today's the day that I take it to the next level. So
upgrades.
The plan for the paint scheme. Now, you came over a couple days ago or yesterday, and we were testing out a few little ones. I took it off so that people can be surprised.
Nice.
But we got a paint scheme in mind. You just want to dive in. Let's paint a little chunk, and we'll show people, and then maybe we can go paint a giant chunk of this because it's going to take a little while.
Yeah, sounds good, man.
I've got, not this one, sorry, one of these is full of paints and sprayers, thanks to you. I'll grab one and I'll throw some cantaloupe. And if you want to grab the other one in here, and it's got, okay. And maybe throw some cyan in there. And I think those got are going to be our two colors to start with. Oops. I'll leave you half these burgers. Oh, and this is cool. I haven't shown people this. So, custom recipe. Aureli went to the trouble of making a molten burger for the Molten Iron server. It takes 20 meat to make. It's one of those custom recipes. Keeps you full for a long time. So, as soon as I get hungry, that's what we're eating.
Yeah, buddy.
Okay, so let's get paint sprayer out. And I probably should have made like a little test wall so I know what sections are what. Here, I got brushes here too. I'll grab a brush so I can test her out. I have a cyan brush already, so we'll just try that. All right, so where's the little section? This little section would be good. Maybe right here, because we got a wall, we got a window frame, and we got one of these things, and we'll see, one of these stone things, and we'll see if I can make them blend in okay. So for the wall, we want the cyan on 2 and 3, and I think that's it for now. I don't want to paint the interior walls yet. So maybe we'll do cyan on 2 and 3, and I'll do the cantaloupe on 1, and I think that'll do that. Okay, so that's the color I want for my adobe, and then, oh, I don't know what the window frame is. You can probably paint the, I don't know. I got a brush, so I'll slap it, because I don't know what's what. We'll figure it out after we do 2 or 3 of these, I'm sure. So 2 and 3 again. I think that might be it for now. What do you think? Should we do should we do those other little areas? I can do them in the cantaloupe, maybe.
Yeah, I'd say try the cantaloupe on the. You're talking the bottom part of the frames.
Yeah. Is that there?
Oh yeah, yeah, it's great.
Okay, so yeah, that's gonna be it, and then this. I'm hoping that when we get, I'm just gonna paint everything on here, cantaloupe, and we'll see how it looks on this. Okay. Oh, that does blend in. That blends in.
That works really well.
Okay. And maybe we'll do little highlights of the cyan on the bars there. Here, you take the cyan brush. I don't know what I'm doing with it. Whoops. Right. I just tried to paint my own body, which I got to do sometime. I got to get some navy blue Braveheart paint on my face. So I think maybe just the little vertical ones in the middle, they're going to be like a 2 or a 3 probably on that.
Yeah, so yeah, just the vertical parts, right?
I think so.
Yeah, that should be 2 then. Okay.
Yeah. What do you think?
Oh, that's fantastic.
I'm so happy that stone blends in. Because I wanted to use the stone because I like how it looks. And I had people go, well, that doesn't match.
Yeah, like when you put it out, I was like, okay, stone.
Oh, it matches. Sure. It matches now. That's right. Okay, so this is our scheme, guys. I think for us to get a big impact for you, we're going to do a bunch. We might do the whole place and come back with you when this thing's looking tip-top. And that'll give us lots of time to do the interior, which might take us a little while. So we're going to take a break. We're going to paint the hell out of this place and come back to you. And welcome back, guys. Me and Aureli here. We have been doing work. Take a look at this. Boom. Place is painted up.
That looks so good.
Cantaloupe and cyan. This is like the angle that makes it look a bit like a villa or a barn, depending. Hopefully not too barny. And then over here,
I think
it's got like a
definitely a villa.
It's got like an apartment block look to it. We ended up losing the pillar that was on the corner there, and I think I like it.
Sorry.
I think I like it better, man. I think I actually like it better. It looks cool. Okay.
This looks great, man.
So paint job complete. We didn't keep you guys with us for most of it because it took a long time. This is what the outside looks like. The inside looks pretty bright too.
Yeah.
I like it. It's not too much. It's enough cyan for me. I'm happy.
The stairs, man, are my favorite.
The stairs, yeah. Check that out. So we did the wood of the stairs. Basically, anywhere you see wood, we did cyan. Anywhere you see clay or adobe, we did cantaloupe. And that's how this place came together. It's pretty much a two-color paint scheme. These sloped roofs, we didn't paint. I tried like 4 different colors on them. Get myself up there. And none of them looked right. So this is the maze-like base we've created. So these are just the plain color, and I think it's the best. If you guys find...
It's disappointing you can't paint the red part, man.
Yeah, the terracotta, the little tiles there. You can only get the clay that goes on top. But if you guys find a good paint scheme for this, let us know. Everything looked way too patchy or way too dark. So we're going to leave it like this. But that was only part 2 of the video. The third part is finishing the inside of the base. It's totally like naked right now. And we got to get in basically everything a good arc base needs.
Yep.
Okay. So, got doors right here, and then we have everything we need, I think, in these chests. So I'll show you what we prepped, mostly with your help. I've got wall torches, lamp posts, electrical stuff, mortar and pestle, got tables, chairs, preserving bins, fridges, generators, fabricators, cookers, grills. I think we're set.
Yep, I've got some of the stuff on me already.
Cool. Where do you want to start?
I think that the harder parts are going to be like the cooking pot, which we did a little prep work on.
Yeah.
And the generator. So I'd probably say the cooking pot's probably the first thing to kind of lay in place.
I'm going to grab some stone railings because the way that we're going to do that, we're going to encircle it a little bit in stone railings. And I think I might make them like too high. Is that what you were thinking?
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Like that. And then they'll be fairly protected.
And then we'll just snap that guy in place.
Okay. Now the other thing I have somewhere are paintbrushes. I gotta go find them. And our jerboas are making that's the electrical storm noise, I think.
Yep, I believe you are correct, which is fine because the generator's not online yet.
Beauty. All right. And let's try, I'm just gonna see what a little bit of cantaloupe paint looks like on these. Oh yeah, they actually look copper. That's kind of got like a steampunky look to it, doesn't it?
Yeah, all right. Yeah.
I'm not going to do any more for now. I think that looks okay. And eventually I'll do those railings, but I'm going to leave them vanilla for now. And do we want to do the grill right next to it?
Yeah, I think that's the best spot for it. I'm just making sure. Okay, so we've got that foundation right there. So we should be good to put it right in as long as we keep it on this side of the foundation.
You can't paint the grill, can you?
I don't think the grill can be painted, unfortunately.
How cool would it be? Like, those look like copper pots. I'd love, like, a copper grill. I'll give it a try as soon as you slap it down.
All right, how straight? Are we looking pretty good? Nope. Let's turn this a little this direction. Oh, that's golden right there.
Boom. Okay. Let's just give this a quick go. Oh, I can slap it with a paintbrush, but there's no regions. What a tease.
I really wish, well, I'm sure that at some point they'll update it so we can do that kind of stuff too. But like the fabricator and stuff is the same way.
You can paint a forge. I know you can paint the industrial forge.
Yeah.
Okay.
Man, that copper looks, doesn't that copper color is
sweet. That's pretty sweet.
Yeah, just get a little cyan up on the handles or the lid.
That's how it should look all the time. I like that.
Yeah. Oh, so I'm apparently dying of thirst. Hold on.
Oh, yeah. There's a tap right up here by these little plants.
Yeah. That's right.
Grab a bevy.
There's the old crop plots.
Yeah. Which have grown in. What do we end up doing here? Is this the citronelle?
Citronelle.
Yeah. Cool. And I think that looks cool. It's orangey, too. Yeah. It looks great. Yeah, we painted these little fences in cyan. Okay, so we get two of the more annoying things. Maybe we go generator, fabricator, and go from there?
Yeah. Yep, I think the Jenny's probably the next one. And I think the best spot, in my opinion, is probably going to be under your staircase here.
Dude,
oh man, that's
those
perfect.
Fit so perfect. I didn't think I was going to be able to do them. Love it.
Oh, that is awesome. All right, so I think that under the staircase is probably going to be the best option for Jenny.
Yeah, I built this area thinking generator here or generator here, but we've played around with some ideas, and I think staircase is probably our way to go.
Yeah, so let's see how close we can get this.
I'm letting Nerali do all the complicated work, guys, because it's
so
better.
He can blame me for it.
No, it's better that way, man. It's the only way it's going to turn out without having to make a bunch of extra stuff. Boom. Looks good.
Yeah, okay. All right.
So, fridge is in. Electricity's in. You can open it. Moment of truth.
Oh, it works. Yeah, buddy.
We did it. And at some point, I'll go get another fridge. I'll slap it in right beside here. We'll do double.
And then I'll cover up that outlet box, too, which would be nice.
Big double-wide fridge. It'll be perfect. Okay, so now fabricator? Perhaps?
Yeah, you want to place the fab and I'll do the smithy?
Sure. So fabricator, is it just going to snap the same way that one snaps?
It doesn't snap
to that
all.
Box? No, but I mean, is it going to connect to that same box?
Doesn't even need electricity. It's just for gas.
Oh, okay. We're golden. Okay. All right. So were we thinking right here? Or
yeah,
have
I
we changed our minds and decided over here?
You should be able to center it right on this wall.
It seems like it. Now, yeah. It's gonna be pretty perfect, actually.
Yeah, that's almost the exact right size for it.
Feel good about this. If it's crooked, it's crooked. Boom. How'd I do?
Oh, that's golden, man.
All right.
Oh yeah, you got it right on the center point.
And you can't paint it copper. I wanted to try.
Son of those sneaky cats.
One of these days. Okay, so we get smithy in. I have a couple of forges.
Yeah, what are you thinking for the forges?
You know, we could do one each in these little corners.
Yeah,
because those are accessible by windows. They're pretty close to the door. I think that could work. Are they middle things still?
Okay. I've got one of them.
I got one too. Do I have three? I might only have two.
Nope. Okay. Yeah. No, you're good. I got the other one.
Okay. What do you think? Facing each other? Like maybe we'll put them close to the corner. I don't know.
Now, do you want to put it on this corner, or do you want to put one in each of the corners like this?
Or you could do two side by side just on the inside of the door, so that they're easy to reach. Here, I'll tuck right up against the door.
So if you guys are watching my video, we just kind of lap the other one to out on the same line, and then we're just going to twist it straight again, and that should put it relatively close to straight.
Mine's a little further out from the wall, but I'm easy. I like, and you can't paint a forge either.
No,
that's one thing you should be able to
paint. Just the industrials. No, right? It's all brick, man.
Yeah. How straight did that turn out?
Oh, that's good, man.
Okay.
Let's look in the back. Yeah, you're golden.
Sliding this way. All right, and there'll be room to expand if I ever want more than three preserving bins.
Yeah. Now, which way do you think you're going to be coming in with, like your sand and cactus sap and stuff?
I mean, maybe over here.
Okay.
That's probably the easiest way, unless
so do you want
putting a gate in somewhere.
We could put, like, your table right here.
Right.
And then your mortars and pestles on that.
And then eventually I'll have to get a chemistry table in, but that's down the road, so
yep.
We can rearrange some stuff by then.
Yeah, you should be fine.
And I think I have more than one table, so once we get upstairs, we can use one for decorative.
Oh my god, I totally forgot about upstairs.
Yeah, we got more stuff. We got another whole level. Okay,
there's so much room for activities.
You can easily fit three mortar and pestle on a table, if I remember.
Yep, that's correct.
But I don't think I can get myself in here anymore. Okay, so maybe can I place the table that way? Place the table in a weird angle. Yeah, I might just do a weird little thing with the table here. What do we think for the other side over here?
Oh, we haven't done anything over there yet.
Okay, so maybe I can actually fit the table in here.
Yeah.
And I can't do it on the other side, so I'll just do it here. Okay, so that's in. I'll take some mortars. And I got one more if I ever need a spot for it. But for now, this will totally work. See that? How crazy is that? I mixed them up. I didn't do them all the same direction.
I like that. That's awesome.
A little random. Cool. Okay, so that's done. Now, what's left? This thing's still full of stuff. So, got some wall torches. I think inside for the wall torches, or do I make them decorative and put them on the outside? I mean, they're going to be more practical on the inside, for sure.
Yeah, they would be practical, but those torches do look pretty cool. Oh, I don't even need to help you.
No, 104, two arrows.
I gotta get
them. These metal arrows are boss.
That's amazing.
Okay, so what am I doing? Distracted.
Wall torches.
Yes. Here, you take two. Right there. And you find a good spot, wherever you think they're going to look good. I'll leave that in your capable hands. I think we are done. Okay, guys, this is the place. You've seen the outside. Now, Orally and I are going to take you through the inside and everything we've done. I don't know, you just want to jump off here real quick? Can we do that?
Yeah.
Okay, so outside, little cooking area. You've got the grill, you've got the cooker, which does dyes and recipes. A little bit of storage over here for gas and whatever else you might need to run it. And yeah, and then we surrounded this, which looks pretty cool. We did the same color scheme on the stone railings, which, by the way, with a paint job, blend right in.
perfect.
Yeah, got some torches up, but then we'll go in. This is the door that I'll probably use to load and unload stuff. I don't know. But then this is the front door. This is the door that has the prettiest entrance. And we got a couple more torches over here. I think that looks awesome.
Yeah.
I'm pretty happy with that. Okay. So you come in this door. You got generator, fridge, eventually another fridge. I've got a little room up here that I could put, make us like a guest bedroom. Got some storage up there. And this can lead, if you want to take the staircase up, I'll meet you on the third floor.
All right.
And we'll finish this thing on the first floor. So this just, for me, comes out to this little balcony over here. And I'm going to meet Rally right at the top of the stairs. Boom. You up here?
Just looked at
him. Oh, yeah. There you go. So these, I thought that would work perfectly, having that second door, but I got to open them both. So it's kind of annoying. And then this is my bedroom. We got a little bed, a little headboard, nice view.
Mm-hmm.
Nice view out here. And then a little storage. And then I think got a personal balcony with maybe the prettiest view. Boom. Want to try it out?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh, with the K mode too. Oh, this is perfect, man.
You like?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Very nice.
Okay. So that's that. This takes us up to the roof. This is the roof access. It's a little bit of a maze-like right now. I may come in and replace this with a big giant trapdoor thing. We'll see. All right. Oh, God, I hate bad design. Terrible design.
It's okay. Perfect, man. It's perfect.
So there's the rooftop.
It'll confuse your enemies.
Yeah. And I think we just got a little of the main floor that we didn't show off because I got distracted and went upstairs first. So wondering, one more entrance over here we haven't tried out.
Yeah.
So we got one here. And actually, you go in that one. I'll go in this one.
Perfect.
This one's lit up too. And this brings us in to the main crafting storage area. What do we got? Bookshelf, smithy, couple of forges, lots of storage.
Do you know what that is in front of you? Have you ever used one of those?
Yeah, I'm vaguely familiar. You can make like some high-end gear, like these bows.
Yeah, that's what I'm told.
Yeah, but I have, believe it or not, I have maybe 400 or 500 hours of Ark in my pocket. Never had one of these in my base.
It's awesome, man.
Yep, I just spend the entire part of the, I spend my entire game at mid-game and early game. So I think that's it, man.
This looks great, man. You did great. I love how this design. I and I know that if you guys are watching my videos and stuff, you know that I am horrible at asymmetrical design. Like it's hard for me. I just can't figure it out. And like when I came over, I was like, oh man, this is exactly how that's supposed to work. This looks perfect.
The one side here doesn't look anything like the other side. Like this is the opposite of symmetrical. Like,
yeah,
they're totally
it's fantastic.
Different. Now I like it. Might need a few standing torches kicking around, and as we go, I'm gonna expand this out. But dude, I went from not having a base, a little bit of help from you using your base, and then a little bit of help from you painting this place up, and now I might have the best base on the whole server.
I think you do, man. This is crazy. This is great.
Boom. Light it up.
You can burn it down, huh?
Yeah. No, that's cool. Man, I know night is falling, so I'll say it. Thank you so much. Is that it? Did I just bow?
You did? I didn't even know you could bow in this game.
True gentleman. All right. That'll work. Cheer me on. All right. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Arali, thank you for your help. Guys, if you're watching me, go check out Arali the Geek on YouTube. Link will be near the top of my description.
It's been great, man.
Yeah, that's it. That's it, brother. Done a massive help to me, and if you guys like this, let us know, and you'll see more of us playing this game together because we both love it.
Absolutely.
Right. Geeks, thank you so much for watching. I'm Unite the Clans. This is Arali the Geek, and we will see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.
Bye.